Wednesday, October 16th. A gorgeous day today. 58 degrees, a little breezy, a little chill, with all of the gorgeous October colors beginning to show themselves. And yes, it has been quite a bit since I've done my last video, some point over the midsummer, I think it was. But I actually decided to take a little bit of time to myself to enjoy the summer away from all of this shit.
Let's say China.
So, I'm not going to ramble on about the shit show.
Yeah!
But I will say one thing that amazes me about it all. People really choose not to realize that the inflation and destruction of all fiat currencies is being brought about by powers outside of this presidential election. People want to blame the current regime for the inflation. People want to say the next regime will fix it. Not going to happen. The Fed controls it. The central banks control it. And presidents do what the fuck they are told. Every single fucking one of them. And that's how it works. So that's about all I'm going to say about this upcoming stupid election that people are so distracted by, because there's a hell of a lot of other shit going on that people are barely taking notice to, like the current weather war situation that is ongoing in the world, particularly at the moment in this country, which I'm sure you've seen by now, the devastation in North Carolina as the news reports all of the rescue efforts that are ongoing by government, and the 200 bodies, and the death toll being at only 200, and all of the other horse shit coming out of their mouths on the mainstream media. But the reality is, thousands of people are dead.
Whatever you think you know about Western North Carolina and what's going on over there, you're wrong, unless you're there. I've debated on if I even wanted to make this video because I don't really want to start a bunch of conspiracy theories or anything like that, but I do feel like word needs to get out about what is actually happening that news is not covering. So here's the facts. I have been assisting with running missions and dispatch for an operations team there for the last week. And last week I was assisting running those missions in Ashe County. I've been in Swannanoa this week, and we've been running 70 missions a day, getting help to these people that are not being helped right now. So when I tell you this is firsthand knowledge, this is firsthand knowledge. The death toll of 200 or 200-ish is what's being reported right now. That's not accurate. My organization sent out 10,000 body bags to local authorities this week, and they're requesting more. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean that all 10,000 of those has been used, but it does mean that they're finding a need, and that they're thinking that they're going to need more. I will tell you, you know, we've spoken to some of the funeral homes and refrigeration truck companies that have been brought in, and there's, you know, 1,000 in this town, 800 in this town, 500 in this town, and we're finding more bodies every day. This is an ongoing process. My team has cadaver dogs that have been going out. We have med teams that are going out. It's not only deaths from the storm, but deaths since the storm.
And thousands of people have lost their homes and their livelihoods. And the people coming together to try to help these victims are local residents, local people, and people from the community. But you would think our benevolent government would love that about the American people. However, they are doing everything they can to demonize those that would try to bring supplies into victims.
I've seen one FEMA agent since I've been here. He approached the front gate of our facility
And his request was, get this, cooperate with local government. Hey, you guys need to cooperate. And we're like, what are you talking about? We have, look at all the law enforcement here. Look at all the firefighters here.
Yeah.
We've had state senators come out here and land. We've had congressmen come out here and land. We've had Fox News here. We've had several other news media here to really capture what we're doing.
Yeah. Then you've got people like me who are I'm just a guy with a phone trying to get the word out because the mainstream media is not doing their job, and so you got a donkey like me trying to do it.
We've been reported to the authorities for domestic terrorism.
Yeah,
we're a bunch of special operation veterans. It doesn't get any more American than what we're doing.
Yeah,
we're here to help the people.
Oh no, you don't. Here's a prime example of a blacked out government helicopter helping at a local distribution center put together by community residents trying to get supplies to people. Check out how much help they gave them.
Just came around here and kicked up everything. Now he's out.
Did they just do that on purpose? Wow, that was crazy. Brother, I got him on camera. But do y'all really think that was on purpose?
Yeah, absolutely.
Exactly.
That's some crazy shit. Yo!
I think JP summed it up pretty clearly for us right here.
Hey, is that the food and water for the victims? Give me that! Hey, I'm with FEMA here to help with hurricane rescue efforts. FEMA, we're very prepared for hurricane season, which means we spent all the money for hurricane rescue efforts on making illegal border crossings as comfortable as possible. FEMA is an important federal agency. FEMA stands for Federal Aviation Emancipation Evacuation Forensics Wrestling Federation Emergency Association. Here in North Carolina, one of the biggest crises that FEMA is facing is an epidemic of citizens trying to help other citizens in need. Kind of ruins everything, doesn't it? Hey, do not pull him from the debris! I know he's being crushed. What's your point? Excuse me, sir. I will literally have you arrested if you use that food to feed people. You take that food to the border where it belongs. Oh, well, you got supplies on that truck or something? Yeah, well, road's completely blocked. Sorry, I can't get through. Well, FEMA's official stance is this road is completely blocked, as you can hear based on what I'm telling you to see. I'm gonna need you to just pull over right there so we can confiscate your supplies and destroy them. Hey, Nigel, I'm gonna need you to burn those pallets of food. FEMA wants to do more, but shucks, we ran out of funding.
I heard FEMA's sitting on $7 billion it's trying to hide.
Turn that camera off, boy.
That is actually your government hard at work. And these are the things that they are capable of doing and are doing currently. Government is not our friend. They are not there for the people, never have been, and never will be. And they are actually behind the devastation as these geoengineered storms are being brought in to various locations around the country, intensified, held in place in order to purposely destroy these communities. So all of you local residents that are doing the American thing and helping out your neighbor, they don't really want that. So that's why they need to deem you domestic terrorists, to try to scare you into not doing it.
I'm scared, Daddy.
Meanwhile, of course, we have another one in Florida that just took place, another one in Acapulco that just took place, and of course, there is the directed energy weapons being used in Wyoming to cause all of these fucking fires.
A 1,000 firefighters are battling a pair of wildfires in Wyoming, with an estimated 100,000 acres burning. Officials say the fires were caused by lightning strikes, but as fast as flames have spread, so have the conspiracy theories. Some social media users floating unproven claims suggesting a connection between the Elk Fire's growth and lithium deposits, alleging global leaders are starting the fires on purpose to clear out the land for lithium mining. Wyoming recently announced lithium discoveries in Natrona County. A Bighorn National Forest, where the Elk Fire is burning, is far from that site. Experts also note hot, dry, and windy conditions have fueled the fires, as crews fight to stop their spread. Evacuations have been ordered across several counties. U.S. Highway 14, one of the main roads in the state, was shut down. The state is taking action to protect livestock and is getting emergency funds from the USDA to help with agricultural recovery. Residents took to social media this week, expressing frustration over lack of media coverage. They note most news outlets are caught up in Hurricane Helene recovery and Hurricane Milton barreling down on Florida.
Yeah, these are the things they don't want you paying attention to. They want you going, Kamala, Trump, Kamala. Oh, I'm sorry, it's Kamala. Kamala now. It's not Kamala anymore. It's Kamala.
I'm Kamala Harris, and I approve this message.
Oh, my God. So they had a chemical plant explosion as well in the Georgia area that had nothing to do with these storms.
Evacuation ordered in Georgia after fire ignites at chemical plant. The latest video will be shown earlier at the official website, theusmilitarynews.com. It's unclear what chemicals are contained in the plume. Some residents in Conyers, Georgia, have received orders to evacuate, while others have been told to shelter in place, following a fire at a chemical plant. Rockdale County Fire Chief Marion McDaniel said on Sunday that the fire was caused by a water-reactive chemical and a sprinkler malfunction. What we know is about 5 o'clock this morning, a sprinkler head malfunction, causing a mixture with a water-reactive chemical, she told reporters. That chemical produced a plume that has been shifting north. McDaniel said it's unclear what chemicals are contained in the plume. She added that the plant was evacuated and everyone in the nearby area is safe. The U.S. Environmental Protection Agency, EPA, was en route to Rockdale, the fire chief said. Images and video of the massive plume have been posted online.
And one of the workers went to testify to question and bring about an investigation into this explosion. But after testifying and bringing this to the attention of government, he ended up dead after his testimony. But again, I'm sure that's haphazard, just like the Boeing employees who also all wound up dead after they reported things in their company. But, you know, the entire fate of the country rides on the election, don't forget, and that's all we're supposed to be talking about. You know, you want to see something interesting? Look at the hurricanes that have come in over the past 7 years. Very intense hurricanes, by the way, down south among the entire coastline.
Coincidence? I think not!
As you can see, these storms, perfectly spaced out along the coastline, are definitely haphazard, and probably because of man-made climate change. They're definitely not being directed, steered, held in place, and intensified to cause mass destruction. Not at all, because that would just be conspiratorial. And if you think that, then you must be a conspiracy theorist, even though all you have to do is investigate and learn about geoengineering a little bit to see that this is what's happening. But I digress. So, anyway, I hope that people will start to realize and take into consideration our current situation and begin to grow the courage to not comply with our own enslavement. It's a nana nana poo poo third grade recess yard game, and most of the people in this fucking country are eating it up. They love the third grade recess yard and the finger pointing and the nana nana poo poo.
Nana nana poo poo.
Because it's the easy road to take. And again, the master psychologists that are actually behind all of this psychological warfare know this, which is why they give that sliver of hope. You know, what was it that President Snow said in the Hunger Games?
Hope. 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 It is the only thing stronger than fear. A little hope is effective. A lot of hope is dangerous. A spark is fine, as long as it's contained.
There you have it. So anyway, we will leave it there for the week. As always, I hope all is well. And we will see you on the next one. Get learning. Get speaking.